Mr. Chen Guozeng is 69 years old. He has been retired for 9 years. After his retirement, he has been making miniature architectural models in this small workshop of only 9 square meters. Before his retirement, Chen worked in the Advanced Technical Training Center of Real Estate Bureau as an instructor who trained senior carpenters. Because of the Cultural Revolution, when Chen was 15 years old, he was forced to leave junior high school and assigned to the housing management office. Later, he was transferred to a technical school to learn architecture. Since wooden structures accounted a large portion in the houses then, he learned techniques related to the construction of wooden structures and worked as a house repairman. After that, Chen began to train and access the candidates in the woodworking training center. While teaching students, he himself also got the qualification certificate for intermediate level workers, advanced level workers, ordinary technicians, and eventually advanced level technicians. And he grew more and more skilled in carpentry. These are the tools Chen usually uses to make miniatures. The main structure of a wood building is mortise tenon structure, composed of tenon and mortise. The quality of the structure affects the quality of the whole building. Chen usually uses chisels to drill holes and saws to make tenons. The teeth of the saw are smaller than those of ordinary hacksaw. These tools are very durable. Mostly made by Chen himself, the tools are made of hardwood or precious wood, such as red sandalwood, huanghua pear, and old mahogany. Chen did not sketch his design on paper before making a miniature. He could make it vividly with only a photo. Due to Chen's keen understanding of wood structure, solid basic skills, and extreme carefulness and patience.
通过自己把小的东西呢做好之后呢，不比大的东西差，很有观赏性，啊，虽然没有实用性，但是它的能把你的内在的技艺啊能反映出来，牵连到比例、加工的方法。
These exquisite miniatures are all made by Chen in a proportion of 1 to 20 to the prototype. The two pavilions are made of red sandalwood, which is characterized by fine texture. It used to be a special wood for the imperial palace and is also a traditional Chinese medicine. Red sandalwood has high iron content and easy to oxidize, so its color will become darker and darker as time goes on. Its oiliness is also good, which promises the building's natural and beautiful luster.
紫檀木它是印度进口的，这个好的这个木材呢，好的红木也是印度进口的，后来到泰国进口，后来缅甸进口的都有。The
prototype of Pavilion Bridge is a scenic spot in Shanghai Grand View Garden. Although it is a miniature, from the width of the bridge span to the height of the Pavilion Bridge, each structure is in the same proportion to the original building structure. The last Pavilion Bridge, also from Shanghai Grand View Garden, is named Peony Pavilion. There are tiles on the two buildings. Because the size and structure of the tiles need to be accurate, and the arrangement needs to be straight and neat, plus their pocket sizes, it is a major difficulty to make and lay the tiles. There are nearly 5,000 tiles in the Peony Pavilion. Each of these two buildings took more than a year to make. The archetype of this archway in the middle is one at the entrance to Zhaojia Tower in Shanghai. It is made of mahogany. Mahogany is Siam rosewood, which is hard, so it has good stability and is not easy to deform. The upper part of the archway is all made up of bracket set, which is the key component of wooden frame structure, connected by tenon and mortise structure. The two buttresses at both ends are trihedral, so it is more difficult to make. An ichthyosaur is carved on it, which is composed of a fish body and a dragon head. This miniature took Chen nearly a year to complete. Prototype of the building is Longhua Tower in Shanghai. Chen started to build it in March this year and has been making it for more than half a year. Longhua Tower originally had 7 floors connected by walls. Now Chen has finished 5 floors. The Longhua Tower needs 144 arms and connection blocks in total, and it will take several days to make only one of them.
那这个形式呢，四个形式，底下是大斗，这里是小斗，因为这个它有角度，有角度要计算，然后还要把它制作出来，是有点难度的啊。它又不是一规则，一般性都是90度的，这是角扣斗拱，夹角135度。
As a carpenter, Chen not only has a good command of woodworking technique and a deep understanding of Chinese architectural structure, but also has a deep interest and love for them.
既然你搞的这行工作了，你有这个技能，你有这个资历，那么我们就搞点，虽然退休了。 搞点自己能搞点东西出来，啊，表示自己有这能力做这个事情，啊，不是说我们要为了钱，那我有钱不能做这个，啊，这个养不活自己，是吧？但从他的艺术角度，他是很好的，啊，是因为是爱喜欢爱好和原来的自己的工作有关，啊，我们就尽量让他发扬光大吧。
Except devoting himself to this hobby, he also wanted to spread and pass on this art, which was the reason why he applied for the wooden structure construction technique to be added to the intangible cultural heritage of Shanghai at that time.
这里边还缺了商业性问题，不是我们一般性都能解决的问题。这个比如说你和你做吧，他解决吃饭问题。 吃饭问题，说弄得好的话呢，很好的；弄得不好的，饭都吃不饱。以前这个学徒是都没有这个机械的，拿个木头就是要么拿斧子劈，要么拿锯子锯。现在这个机械发展太快了，整个的这个势头啊，太猛了，发展太快，所以说要做的，一般性人家没事，没有事情，有稳定的工作。 退休了，啊，稳定的收入，把人家做的往往做这个，但怎么样把发展下去呢？还动动脑筋，能不能发展下去？这个趋势呢，也是一个比较难的问题。如果20年之后我们不能做了，那怎么办？是吧？这个问题呢，还要也不是所谓说简单的三句话两句话能说得好的。 但是很多机器代替了，但是很多有很多东西不能代替，还需要手工做的，这就看着将来的发展，我们主要是有人如果学的话，我们把它传承下去，我们只能做到这一点，希望那个更多人的关系这个问题吧，参加这个行业。
With the development of society, carpentry is no longer a means to make a living. But the wisdom of our ancestors, the persistence and pursuit of craftsmen it contains need to be well inherited and carried on. Although this skill may not be a tool to make a living anymore, it can become a narrator of history, a communicator of culture, and an elegant pleasure in people's busy life. Before that, it needs to be spread, understood, and learned. Only in this way can it continue to exist.